कैस्केड कंट्रोल एक्शन, प्रिंसिपल ऑफ कैस्केड सिस्टम। कैस्केड इज सिंपल एंड मोस्ट इफेक्टिव मेथड टू एलिमिनेट द मेंटेन्ड एंड रैपिड सिग्नल्स इज द यूज ऑफ कैस्केड कंट्रोल एक्शन। इन ए कैस्केड सिस्टम द सर्क्यूट इज डिवाइडेड इंटू डिफरेंट जोन्स इन विच द एयर सप्लाई इज लैचड बाय एडिशनल डायरेक्शन कंट्रोल वॉल। The principle of a cascade system is as follows. First one, follow a simple design procedure to determine the minimum number of groups in the circuit. To eliminate the trapped signals, allocate the signal wall limit switches between these groups. Second one, unlike the previous circuits where a single supply bus bar was used to carry the main supply pressure to all components in a cascade system, a separate supply bus bar is provided to each group. Third one, provide a conventional arrangement of selector walls to direct the supply only to the active group. Cylinder A and B. The diagram indicating cascade circuit design. Signal elimination technique. In this technique, it is possible to eliminate signals either mechanically or by means of suitable circuitry. Mechanical methods. In this method, the signal elimination is by means of a short impulse transmitter or B, idle return roller. Short impulse transmitter method is composed of direction control wall with over center function and the respective type of control. When using such a type of wall, one should have the following points. The operating reliability depends to a great extent on the speed of actuation, maximum 0.1 to 0.15 meters per second. The wall is actuated in the middle part of the stroke and not at the ends of the stroke. That is, the actuator must be operated as far from the stop, otherwise a continuous signal will exist. Idle return roller can be used if the signal to be eliminated is provided by a limit switch. The use of roller lever walls with idle return to eliminate signal overlapping has the following disadvantages. The end position cannot be sensed accurately. Function may be impaired due to contamination. Fast control of systems are not possible.